house and began to spread some papers he was holding.
Hola.
Take a look. After all, I went to the trouble of gathering all this. I see, so the reason you snuck inside everyone's cottages was... That's right, I wanted to get a sample of everybody's footprints. But unfortunately, Fuyuhiko wouldn't leave his cottage, so I couldn't complete it. Well, I guess it's no big deal. It seems obvious that the footprints belong to this person. Hiyoko Sayonji. Hiyoko's. To be honest, the reason I summoned her to the airport was so I could lure her out of her cottage. She shut herself inside her cottage, remember? If she stayed in there, I couldn't sneak in. You're treating her like a small animal. But it was totally worth it. The footprint I collected there was smaller than anyone else's and matched the footprints at the beach house. Yep, there is no mistake. These are Hiyoko's footprints. Also, it's not like I was snooping around or anything, but I found something really interesting at her cottage. I found a lot of these candies inside her room. That's... They're gummy candies that come in 4 different flavors. Strawberry, melon, grape, and orange. It looks like she got it from the supermarket. Apparently she really likes this brand of gummies. Which literally says gummy on it. There should have been other gummy brands, but she only brought home a bunch of these. People are like that sometimes. There are people who will only eat the same brand, even if it's just potato chips. What's wrong with that? Well, it's not clear if this relates to the incident, but I thought I should tell you just in case. Okay. He was telling me about what he just... What's up? Listen, I have big news. Huge news. What's the big news? Remember that sandwich Espe Ito mask that was next to Mahiro's body? Oh, the mask the killer used to hide their face. No, that is not correct. That mask was just not used to hide their face. Then, what was it for? Sparkling justice! Huh? Sparkling Justice is a serial killer and self-professed ally of justice whose name makes mankind shudder. They wear a hero mask at all times. Supposedly, they are a serial killer who only murders other criminals. Do not look so disappointed, Hajime. You need to be surprised. This Sparkling Justice character, that's the serial killer you were talking about before, right? It's true that the mask we found is a hero mask, but... It is a heroine mask, to be precise. Sunwitch Espe Ito is a pretty witch girl. See? A heroine! But anyway, so you're saying it's possible that this serial killer is the one who killed Mahiro? Which means... There's a serial killer hiding among us. I'm pretty sure I've seen a twist like this in some video game! Are you serious? This is stupid. Serial killer my ass. The killer just uses to cover their face. But even so, they sure show something that stands out. Although it's easy to write this off as foolish, it might be best if we exercise some caution. Sonia, can you tell me everything you know about this so-called sparkling justice? The hell? What the heck was that? That is Sparkling Justice's catchphrase. An unknown serial killer has a catchphrase. I read it in a magazine in the library. There's only ever been one person, a journalist, who has interviewed Sparkling Justice. The article was written in their native language, so I tried translating it. However, in the end, that journalist was punished by Sparkling Justice too. No good can come from getting involved with a serial killer. The serial killer might not want to hear that from you. This is all I know about Sparkling Justice. Thanks to the masks, nobody knows their true age or gender, making them a very mysterious individual. Hey, isn't that kind of a stretch? To say that there's a serial killer hiding in our group. No, it does not mean they are in our group. It is possible the serial killer was lurking on this island all along before they decided to murder Mahiru. That's probably not possible. But that is the only thing I can think of. I mean, no matter how much I think about it, I simply cannot believe it. That one of us is capable of committing such a horrible murder. No matter how much I think about it, I simply cannot believe it. Sonia? I do understand Sonia's feelings, but it's highly unlikely that there is a serial killer hiding on this island. Mikan, you had something to say too, right? Well, compared to the others, what I have to say isn't that important. So please don't get your hopes up and be disappointed. I get it, so just get on with it. I tried my best to perform the autopsy, and I was able to find out. Mahiru was definitely killed by a blow to the head. She was probably struck from behind by one blow. Based on the scar, the weapon is clearly the metal bat. But every dark cloud has a silver lining, as they say. It looks like Mahiru didn't suffer. What does that mean? There's no doubt that she died instantly. Her death was instant. That sounds a little strange. I think I'd better remember that. And there's another thing I found. I'm sorry, I started talking on my own. Were you busy right now? Just tell me. During the autopsy, I discovered this in Mahira's pocket. I was going to tell you in person, but I couldn't find you, so I put this in your mailbox. About what we discussed earlier, is it okay if we change the place and time? I want you to come to the beach house on the second island at 2:30 PM. It seems there is someone who wants to interfere with our meeting. Let's keep it a secret. Until then, let's try not to see each other for a while. It would be bad if they started suspecting us for no reason. Hiyoko Sayonji. This letter. If this letter is real, it would mean Hiyoko met up with Mahira, right? Plus, Mahira's estimated time of death was around 3 PM, and they met 30 minutes prior. If we think about what that implies, then... Oh, I'm starting to get confused. If it's true, what does it mean? What happened between Mahira and Hiyoko? It's time.
Yosh.
We should start heading over. At the trial field where Monokuma is waiting. I have to make my case there. There is no escape. We have no choice but to press forward. And now then, let us go. As we talked among ourselves, we left the beach house and Mahira's body.
Ugh!
For Yuhiko. What? What? I'm right here. What is wrong with this game? This is so ridiculous. Konnichiwa. Matte ne. Yabe na koryan. So, no, that doesn't mean anything. It Monokuma's own body doesn't really say anything about whether the one who controlling the robot is actually a girl or a guy. Girl or a boy. Once again. I can only... Moving forward is the only option. Okay. Just go. So ridiculous.
Yeah.
Mahiri Koizumi, the ultimate photographer. She had an unyielding force of personality, but she was actually very good at taking care of people. Most importantly, she was always straightforward. The person that killed her is among us. I don't want to believe it. I don't want to believe it. I don't want to believe it, but... regardless, we need to find the answer. It doesn't matter if you believe it or not. Because it's the only way. Aside from finding out who the killer is, there is no other way for us to survive. And so, this life-threatening trial, billowing with hope and despair, has begun. Alright, so, as always, we'll get back to this some other time, but for now, this investigation has been quite interesting. The game is moving at a pace which is not entirely surprising to me. I don't know. It's like I said before, you really shouldn't play this game if you have not played the first game. But if you have played the first game and you play this one, there are just... sometimes there's just things that stand out to you, which I haven't talked about. I mean, I haven't discussed it in full, but you can probably guess some of the things based on my reactions. But I don't think there's any point to every time once I've done with a recording start asking myself questions about things I don't know about yet. But things will get revealed in due time. So, I'm just along for the ride and see what happens. And if some of my guesses are correct, then... I don't know, what do I expect? Would I get disappointed if I'm correct? Possibly. This game tends to throw twists at me, so I'm pretty used to not always be completely right, sometimes even completely wrong. Enough about that. So I hope you guys are enjoying this, and next time we will take on the second class trial. And because, we will also take a break in between when the interlude starts halfway through. And hopefully I will have a better grasp of the different minigames this time. So I'll see you guys next time, and thank you for watching.